Hello, Vinyl Community, Dave the Pickup Artist, with you for another round of Psychedelic Sunday. I've got some interesting albums this week. First, I got a couple albums from Eric Burdon and the Animals. Most of you know the Animals as an R&B band from the mid-60s, but as the 60s progressed, they did a couple of great psychedelic albums. And the first one I've got is Winds of Change.
No colors in my life, you better turn them black.
They kind of broke up in 66. Eric Burdon moved to San Francisco. While in San Francisco, he formed a new psychedelic version of the Animals. And this is what they put out, Winds of Change. I don't like this album cover. I don't like the words on it. I would prefer something else. That being said, this is an excellent album. We open it up with the title track, Winds of Change, a great sitar rock song. They go into a great version of the Stones, Paint It Black. After that, we've got a strange one. We've got a spoken word track called the Black Plague, where Eric, it sounds like, if you close your eyes, you think you're in a Hammer horror film.
A woman in black cries as the deathly procession passes by, and monks moan in mass. The yet clean peasant pounds upon the castle door, for it is safer inside the walls.
This is actually what we're listening to in the background, The Black Plague, the track four from side one. And side one closes with a track called Yes, I Am Experienced, which is a kind of a track in honor of his friend Jimi Hendrix, kind of a joke. Of course, Jimi Hendrix had the song Are You Experienced? And in this song, Eric is answering him back, saying, yes, I am experienced. Yeah, they were good friends. Now, side two opens with a nice track called San Francisco Nights, a great organ-driven track, which I think was released as a single.
On a warm San Francisco night, old child, young child, feel alright. On a warm San Francisco night, angels sing, leather wings, jeans of blue, Harley Davidson's too. On a warm San Francisco night, oh, don't you know?
yeah, this is just a fantastic psychedelic album. A year prior to this, Eric had just taken his first dose of LSD, and he was writing more psychedelic stuff. And yeah, this is just a fantastic album. I think this is my favorite. But they followed it up. This came out in 67. And they followed it up with an equally great album called The Twain Shall Meet. This is early 68. And this is another great psychedelic Eric Burton and the Animals album. It opens up with Monterey. They had appeared at Monterey and had a great time, and Eric wrote a song about it, shouting out a lot of the bands that were there. A great track. Then we go to side two, and we've got a, I think it's an 8-minute anti-war psychedelic track called Sky Pilot. I believe this might have been released as a single in a edited form. And yeah, there's just a lot of good stuff on here also. I don't know which one I like better. I think I probably like the first one better, but... dropped out, started taking acid, and he put out some great psychedelic albums in 67 and 68. Definitely worth checking out.
We got us some good ones.
So I wanted to listen to some Grateful Dead this week, and one of my favorite Grateful Dead albums isn't a Grateful Dead album. It's a Bob Weir album. I'm talking Ace, 1972. Now this is Bob Weir's first solo album. The thing is, every member of the Grateful Dead plays on it. And another thing, and the thing that's most cool about this album is every song on here would go on to be in the Grateful Dead's live set. We're talking Walk in the Sunshine, Playing in the Band, One More Saturday Night, Cassidy. Every track on here would be a Grateful Dead live staple. It's a great album. And we got Playing in the Band was a great track live, because what they would do is they'd go into the start of the song, then they'd delve into something completely different, some sort of bizarre jam, then they go back to it, reprise. And the same thing with One More Saturday Night. That's another track that you would likely hear in a Dead set. Hey, Saturday night. one more Saturday night, I watched the documentary on Bob Weir. I believe it was Netflix. I believe it was called The Other One. And Bob says that for about a year, every Saturday night, he would drop acid with, I guess, the rest of the members of the Dead or the Ken Kesey group. I don't know, but he said he was regularly for about a year. I imagine the year is 67, 68. But yeah, it's a great song. And he toured as he had a band called Rat Dog, and he would play in the St. Augustine Amphitheater. I saw them, and I believe he did. Yeah, I'm pretty sure he did One More Saturday Night. Yeah, this is a great album. It's on it's on the Grateful Dead label, kind of logo label. Warner Brothers, I guess. And I gotta say, most of my Grateful Dead albums are on CD. And what I love is the Dick's Picks releases that they started putting out in the 90s. And they've recently started putting these out on vinyl. The first one I've got is Dick's Picks Volume 1. This is Tampa, Florida. This is a 2-CD set. And we've got Here Comes Sunshine. This is from 1973, Tampa. And Tampa is where I saw the Dead in 95, one of their last show in Tampa. So I definitely had to pick this one up, Dick's Picks 1. Then I have Volume 2. This is Columbus, Ohio in 71. If I was 5 or 10 years older, I might have got to see this show in Columbus. I was living in Marion, which is 40 miles north of Columbus. But we've got a great Dark Star on this particular CD, Dark Star, but it's only one CD. I don't know why that is. I'm sure the show was longer than that. That might have been the only thing they were able to capture on tape. Dick's Picks Volume 3. We've got Pembroke Pines, Florida, 1977. This is a 2-CD set. Next one is Dick's Picks Volume 4. This is the Fillmore East, 1970. This has got 3 discs in it. And we've got a version of Casey Jones, an early version of Live Casey Jones, and another great version of Dark Star on here. Not much to these. We don't have a lot of liner notes in these sets. We get a little bit of stuff, but nothing major. These were basically no-frills CDs. And the last one I have is Volume 5. This is Oakland Auditorium, 1979. And this is a 3-disc set. And we've got the great drums. They do drums on here. Some of you deadheads are familiar with drums. It's a heavy percussion, kind of like Dark Star with drums, basically. And yeah, these are great if you can find them. They are eventually putting them all out on vinyl, though, I imagine. They've already put out a few of the first ones, but yeah, Grateful Dead. Next, I've got some dollar bin finds. Up first, I got from the dollar bin, Richie Havens' Alarm Clock. It's been a long, long, lonely winter. Now, darling, Finds Richie in 1971, and this is actually his highest charting album. It opens with a cover of Here Comes the Sun by George Harrison, and it does have some electric guitar in it. He's on rhythm guitar and acoustic guitar, but he's also got a lead guitar player. And track two has a guest appearance by Rick Derringer on electric guitar. It's on the Stormy Forest label. And yeah, that was in the dollar bin. Another dollar bin I have is Janis Joplin, Mama, I Got Them Old Cosmic Blues Again. This is, I believe, her first solo album after leaving Big Brother and right before she joined the Full Tilt Boogie Band. Now, there are some members of the Full Tilt Boogie Band on here, I believe, and she's also got, despite leaving Big Brother, she brought along Sam Andrews from Big Brother for this album. And this is she's getting away from the psychedelic and getting into more of a soul type situation. We've got some great tracks here. We've got side one. The first song has Try, which was a single, great single. First track on side two has To Love Somebody, which is a Bee Gees cover. Very nice Bee Gees cover. And another great album from Janis Joplin. In the dollar bin. Next, I found this one. I picked this up. This was actually in the $2 bin. I've got Clapton. Now, I didn't know what to make of this. First of all, this sticker here, this Clapton is an actual sticker. I don't know what that's all about, but the back cover, it took me a while to figure out what this was about, but it's actually Clapton's standout tracks with Derek and the Dominoes and Delaney and Bonnie. I believe that's what this is. We get, all the other players, we get the great players from Delaney, Bonnie, and Derek and the Dominoes, Dwayne Allman, Bonnie Bramlett's on this, Rita Coolidge, Jim Gordon, of course Jim Gordon is on this, Leon Russell, Stephen Stills is on guitar on one of the tracks, and yeah, all-star cast, another great dollar bin pickup. I often find Bob Dylan in the bins, not his records, the real Bob Dylan. And my last one here is a bit of Bosstown lounge psychedelia in the form of Orpheus. And I don't know what, I think this might be their first album. They were another Boston band that would open for some of the bigger bands that would end up in the Boston area. And also some of the British Invasion bands that would end up in the Boston area.
Petals beneath me. Couldn't go.